In this lecture, we are discussing about the excess carriers in semiconductor. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the thermal equilibrium, electron and hole concentrations. So, the charge carriers in semiconductors which are in excess of their thermal equilibrium value are called excess carriers. So, how can we create excess, or how can we generate excess carriers in semiconductors? There are several methods for generation, like optical excitation. So by optical excitation or optical absorption method, optical excitation, then electron bombardment, then also injection across a p-n junction. So there were several methods of generation are available. So here in this session we are going to discuss about the photo generation or optical absorption method of generating excess carriers. So we are going to discuss about the optical excitation process or the photo generation process. So this is also known as photo generation or optical absorption method for generating excess carriers. So excess carriers can be generated by the photo generation methods, and in this process we are passing light on the semiconductor. So if a photon of energy greater than the band gap of semiconductor falls on the semiconductor, the energy of the photon is absorbed by an electron in the valence band and it is excited to the conduction band. So we are passing light to the semiconductor, or we are passing a photon of energy h nu greater than Eg. So we are passing a photon of energy greater than Eg. Eg is the band gap. Eg is the band gap. So Eg is the band gap of the semiconductor, energy, forbidden energy band gap. So we are passing a photon of light, photon of energy h nu greater than Eg to a semiconductor. So this energy is absorbed by an electron in the valence band, and it is excited to the conduction band, and this result in an electron hole pair. So a hole will be generated in the valence band and the excited electron will be in the conduction band. So an electron hole pair will be created. So this optical generation method will create equal number of electron and hole concentrations. So we can say this electron value, that is excess carrier, delta n will be equal to delta p. So it is created in pairs. So electron hole pairs will be generated by this optical generation method. So this carrier concentration are in excess of their thermal equilibrium value, and we can denote it as n. So n0 is thermal equilibrium value and delta n is the excess electrons created by optical absorption. Similarly, for holes, p0 is the equilibrium value and delta p is the excess carriers generated. So delta n and delta p are the excess electron and hole concentration. So for the optical absorption method, the condition is the photon of energy should be greater than Eg. So if a photon of energy h nu greater than Eg is applied, then this electron will be excited to a higher energy level, to a higher energy level in the conduction band, not at this edge. It will excite to a higher energy level since the energy is very much greater than Eg. So it will excite to a higher energy level in the conduction band, and it will not be stable there. It will release some heat, it will release some heat in the semiconductor, and it will come to the edge of the conduction band, that is at EC. So this is what it is, that is due to some scattering, due to some scattering events, some heat will be generated, and it will move to the conduction band. Then after this, the recombination, so this is the generation, the excitation means the generation process, electron hole pairs are generated, and next the recombination process, so actually the reverse process will be recombination, that is the electron will come and occupy a vacancy in the valence band. So this electron hole recombination will occur. Here it is a direct recombination process is showing. So the electron from the conduction band will come and occupy a hole in the valence band. During this recombination process, a photon of energy may be released during this direct recombination process. So this principle is used in LEDs. So LED, the working principle is electroluminescence, or in that direct recombination, so or direct band gap semiconductors are used for manufacturing LED, silicon, germanium, so they are easily available, but we are not using silicon for manufacturing LED. We are using the compound semiconductors, gallium phosphate, gallium nitride, etc. are used for manufacturing LED, since they are direct band gap semiconductors. Only direct band gap semiconductors are used for manufacturing LEDs. So direct band gap semiconductors means the recombination is occurring directly, that is from the conduction band to valence band, without any trapping levels. Or so we will discuss later about the different recombination mechanisms. So so this is simply the generation recombination occurring in a semiconductors. So this electron hole pairs are generated in equal concentrations. So next, so if we pass a photon of energy to a semiconductor of thickness T, so we are passing the light, this is the photon or the light with intensity I0. So I0 is intensity of light passing through a semiconductor of thickness T, and this is the transmitted light I of T. So some recombination will occur, some generation and recombination will occur, that is the incoming light intensity is absorbed, and some recombination process will also occur in the semiconductor, and this is the transmitted light I of T. I of T is the transmitted light, so we can write the expression for I of T as I0 into e raised to minus alpha T, where alpha is the absorption coefficient. So here we are plotting the absorption coefficient as a function of the photon energy. If the incident photon has an energy greater than the band gap energy, the velocity of the excited electron will be higher, and the excess energy of the electron is released to the lattice, as we already discussed, as heat during the scattering events, until its velocity become the thermal velocity at that temperature. So some energy is dissipated in the semiconductor itself as a scattering process in the form of heat. So so this is the expression for I of T. I of T is the transmitted light equation, that is I of T is equal to I0 e raised to minus alpha T. So next we are going to discuss about two types of injection process, that is low level and high level injection. So low level injection and high level injection. So what is meant by low level injection? So when the excess carrier concentration is small compared to the equilibrium majority carrier concentration, it is said to be low level injection. So we have created the excess carriers delta N and delta P, and if the value of delta N is very much less than N0, and if the value of delta P very much less than P0, that is the majority carrier concentration N0, or the equilibrium value, if delta N is very much less than the equilibrium value N0, then we can say that this type of injection is known as low level injection. And for high level injection, the excess carrier concentration should be comparable or equal to or greater than the equilibrium concentration. So if the value of delta N is equal to or greater than the value of N0, or delta P equal to or greater than P0, so this type of injection is known as high level injection. So this depends upon the incident light. So high level, and this is low level injection. So this is known as low level injection. So in doing problem, it may be specified whether it is low level injection and high level injection. So we will in some derivation also we will assume the injection process is low level, and sometimes it will be high level injection. So these are the two type of injection process. And next we are going to discuss about steady state carrier generation. Steady state carrier generation. Or through this topic, we are going to derive an equation for this excess carriers in terms of optical generation rate. So in the previous section, under thermal equilibrium condition, we have studied that the generation rate is balanced by recombination rate. That is, the generation rate at thermal equilibrium, G of T, can be, or it is proportional to the square of Ni, or intrinsic carrier concentration, or it is proportional to N0 P0. We have already studied that. So G of T can be written as alpha R into Ni square, or it is equal to alpha R into N0 P0. So the generation rate at thermal equilibrium is proportional to the product of the equilibrium electron and hole concentration, or that proportionality is replaced by alpha R. Alpha R is the recombination rate. So N0 P0 is equal to Ni square. So this can be written as alpha R into Ni square. So this is the generation rate at thermal equilibrium. So now we are considering a steady state optical generation rate. So we are considering a steady state optical generation rate, GOP, added to the thermal equilibrium value. So we are adding the steady state optical generation, that is after passing light to the semiconductor, with this thermal generation rate. So now the carrier concentration will increase to a new value. So we know that the value of N0 will increase to N0 plus delta N, and the P0 value will change from P0 to P0 plus delta P. So under steady state condition, we can write G of T plus G of P, that is the thermal equilibrium value plus GOP. GOP means after passing light to the semiconductor, the carrier concentration will increase. So this can be replaced by alpha R into NP, not N0 P0, alpha R into NP, where N is N0 plus delta N, where N is N0 plus delta N and P is P0 plus delta P. Since the value of equilibrium value is increased to N0 plus delta N, delta N is the excess carriers generated since we are passing light to the semiconductor. So this is the new generation rate after passing light. So this is equal to alpha R into N can be replaced by N0 plus delta N and P can be replaced by P0 plus delta P. So again we can open this, we can multiply these two terms. So this is equal to N0 P0 plus N0 into delta P plus P0 into delta N plus delta N into delta P. So we are we are assuming it is low level injection, and we are assuming low level injection, assuming low level injection, and also direct recombination is occurring, and direct recombination is occurring in the semiconductor. So we can write delta N is approximately is or equal to, this can be equal to delta P, and this is low level injection means the value of delta N will be very small also. So we can write G of T plus G of P is equal to alpha R into N0 P0 plus this N0 delta P can be replaced by delta N, here P0 plus delta N. So since delta P and delta N are equal, we can take delta N as common. So N0 plus P0 plus delta N into delta P means delta N into delta N. Since delta N and delta P are equal, so this term will become delta N square. And if you open this bracket, alpha R into N0 P0 plus alpha R into delta N into N0 plus P0. And since delta N is very small due to low level injection, the delta N square value will be very small. So we can neglect the rest of the term. So our equation delta N square is neglected. N square is neglected. Reason, low level injection. Low level injection means the value is very small. Delta N value is very small. So we are neglecting the value of delta N square. So this equation becomes G of T plus G of P is equal to alpha R into N0 P0 plus alpha R into delta N into N0 plus P0. So from equation 1 we can write G of T as alpha R into N0 P0, and this is from equation 1, and this is equal to alpha R into N0 P0 plus G of P is equal to alpha R into N0 P0 plus alpha R into N0 plus P0 into delta N. So here delta N is there. So we can cancel this and this. So G of T is replaced by alpha from equation 1. So we can write G of P. G of P is equal to alpha R into delta N into N0 plus P0. From this again one assumption, that is this can be replaced by delta n by tau n. So GOP is equal to, we are getting an optical generation rate expression, GOP is equal to delta n by tau n, where tau n is equal to 1 by alpha r into n0 plus p0, where tau n is known as the recombination lifetime or the carrier lifetime. So this is the expression for GOP, or from this we can write the expression for delta n as GOP into tau n. So cross multiplying we get different equations. So GOP is equal to delta n by tau n, or since delta n is equal to delta p, we can write it as GOP is equal to delta p by tau n. So since delta n is equal to delta p, so this is the expression for optical generation rate. So this equation is important, and you have to study the value of tau n also. So tau n is equal to 1 by alpha r n0 plus p0. So this is important. So some problems will be asked from this topic. So optical generation rate GOP is equal to delta n by tau n. Next session we will study about the different recombination mechanisms occurring in a semiconductor. So in the next lecture we will discuss about that. So thank you.